Okay, let's talk about my grocery haul. You might have seen the grocery store video that we brought Pat to that ended up just being what it's like to bring Pat to the grocery store
instead of
what I buy. So we have divided the groceries in protein, carbohydrate, starch carbohydrate,
fruit carbohydrate,
fats, and this is a new addition for me, is manuka honey. You might have heard me say over and over, I'm trying to give up artificial sweeteners and I am slowly shifting to honey and monk fruit. I hear that manuka is really healing, so I thought I'd start with the Trader Joe's ones because it's $13 rather than going somewhere and buying a $60 one and not liking it. One of these is for Pat's. I go no salt almond butter. Pat goes salted fat. I mean salted peanut butter.
This is salted fat.
I bought butter if you want any, by the way, for Pat. All right, berries are low glycemic. They do count as a carb. I love me berries. Right now I'm really into raspberries, strawberries. I'm not as into blueberries and blackberries currently. Maybe they're just not as in season or not as good. So those are some berries I also eat. Bananas are like a once in a while treat. Personally, my body doesn't respond as well to eating bananas all the time. I start to notice them on my gullet.
Fruit
gullet. And remember, all of this is what works for me. This isn't the only way or the right way. Y'all ask me what I eat, and here's what I eat. And remember, I'm healing my gallbladder, and I have gallbladder sensitivity, so I'm much more limited to what I can eat than someone who's just starting their health journey. You have way more possibilities, and I don't want you to feel like, how does she do that? You know, as your health journey progresses, you might want to step it up and get gnarlier and gnarlier. You know, from a beginner standpoint, it might seem gnarly, where for me, it's just like more fun and more fun to see how much I can fine tune my body. So remember, this is just what I do. I just found these at Trader Joe's. Squashes are one thing that my gut can handle. This is a honey nut squash. So excited to try this. Always have a sweet potato around because you'll never know when you need some sweet potato. Again, squashes are totally good. Carrots I used to avoid because technically they're higher sugar, but because my veggie list is really shrinked, I've been really into broiling chicken. It's a lot. I used to only buy these, but it goes so fast that now a whole chicken will last me a lot longer, and I've been really into like how clean and the broil taste. And instead of using like avocado or almonds, I've been eating the dark meat to get some of my fats. I've been into the whole chicken, and I'll put the carrots in there. Portobello mushrooms, is from Rudy's belly growl. Mm-hmm. Portobello mushrooms are delish. Also, I believe even though they're a carb, they do have protein in them, like a lot of vegetarian vegans eat them. So I love those. And then I get the barbecue cut just because I like to make it on the BBQ. And then the great thing about eating salmon is I stopped buying so many dog treats for my dogs, and I just give them the skin of the salmon. I give them sweet potato. They can have carrots. Why buy them processed food? I don't eat processed food. I get them dehydrated chicken, but otherwise I give them my healthy food. I do a combination of eggs and egg whites, mostly egg whites, if I want like almond butter with my breakfast. But if I want my fats from eggs, sometimes I'll add some eggs with egg whites. And yeah, I pretty much keep it to these. I already had some groceries in my fridge, so I didn't need to get everything. So let me pull out some other things that I buy on the regular. So I used to buy the microwavable brown rice because it was quick and easy, and I like just never felt good about microwaving plastic. So I finally switched to this. I don't know why I chose long grain. And I've been hearing rumors that brown rice, you might be better off white. So I'm gonna dive deeper into some of my research on that. Apparently brown has a lot less starches or something. I don't know, I need to look into it. I'm open to switching to white if this is more processed and not great for you. $20 on Amazon, don't judge me. I made my oatmeal this morning and it's messy, but it's a mini rice cooker. So I never used to buy the microwave that kind of rice because I never successfully made it. It was just like too dry or like not cooked enough. So this little pup, $20 on Amazon. I make my steel cup oatmeal in here too. So sweet yam. I meant to buy a sweet potato. Whatever, we'll have yams. Always keep doing some avocados around. Typically I like avocados more in the summer with salads. Right now I'm not. I'm trying to avoid eating raw, just again, to heal heal my gallbladder. Lately, I've been really into cooking spinach down and mixing it with brown rice. Bomb. Green apples are also really low glycemic, a carbohydrate. Oh my gosh, my new discovery. Chayote. Chayote. Squash. A product from Mexico. Delicious. You can eat them raw, which I'm not doing right now. I baked them. Is that what you call it? Broiled them? They were so good. Apparently they adapt the flavor of anything you make with them. So like if you wanted to go curry, you know, they'll follow along. Collard greens? No. This is rainbow chard. The rainbow chard. I need to cook these today, clearly. Asparagus. Pretty much what my stomach can handle right now. And oatmeal. I add these as well. And because they're made with coconut oil, they're not like super high in carbs, but they do have some fat, so these are always fun too. That wraps up my grocery haul. I hope that's helpful into where to start. It's unfortunately, you know, there's all the diets in the world you want, keto, intermittent fasting. Yeah, those things work, but if you're not doing them healthy, like if you are intermittent fasting and you're eating healthy food in those 8 hours, whatever the fuck it is you're allowed to eat, you're not gonna get the best results, you know, or you're gonna crash because you're it's not gonna be sustainable because there's no trick to it. It's clean, healthy ingredients, day in and day out. Consistency. Hear me, Oleg? Not, oh, I'm going to Ukraine. I need to lose some weight. I'm gonna bet with my friends. And the diet's over and you're like, where's the check? And that's it.
That's it.